Hi children, how are you? Hope you're all doing good. Fine. Very good children. So before going to start our session, let's start with prayer, right? Fine. Join your hands, close your eyes, stay calm and listen to me. Right? Asatoma Satgamaya Tamaso ma Jyotirgamaya Mrityoma Mardangamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Fine children, now rub your hands, have a gentle pressure on your eyes. Very good. Now slowly open your eyes, children. Fine. So, children, what did we saw in last sessions? We saw about nervous system. Right. What is nervous system? It comprises of brain, spinal cord, nerves and sensory organs in which the messages can be passed to and from brain to all parts of the body. Right. So among these organs, brain is considered as the most active member of nervous system. Okay. And we saw about parts of nervous system. What are the parts? Central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Right. Brain and spinal cord comprises of central nervous system, whereas sensory nerves, motor nerves and mixed nerves comprises of peripheral nervous system, right? So, initially we saw about central nervous system, okay? In central nervous system, the organs present are brain and spinal cord, okay? We saw about brain. So, what is brain? It is the active member. It acts as the control tower, right? It is the control tower of the body. It controls all the actions that we are performing, right? What it controls? It controls all the actions we are performing. So, it termed as control tower of a body and it is located under the bony skull, right? And the cerebrum is, the brain is divided into three parts, namely cerebrum, cerebellum and medulla oblongata. Could you clear? So what is cerebrum? It is larger part of the brain and it is used for thinking purpose, right? Then cerebellum, it is found at the rear end of the brain, which is responsible for muscle movement. Okay, and medulla oblongata, it is the stem-like structure, which is responsible for breathing and heart rate. Okay, so cerebellum is split into two hemispheres, left and right. Left hemisphere controls right side of the body, whereas right hemisphere controls left side of the body. Okay. Then what are the functions? Speech, learning, memory, intelligence, reasoning, decision making and imagination. Okay. Then coming to cerebellum. It is rear part of the brain located under the cerebrum. Okay. And its functions are coordinates muscle movement and maintains balance of the body. Could you clear? Then medulla oblongata, it is present at the lower part of the brain and it looks like stem. Okay, it connects cerebrum and cerebellum to the spinal cord. Okay, it controls breathing, heart rate and other involuntary muscles, right? So today we are going to see about spinal cord. Okay, children, see at this picture how the spinal cord looks like. Okay, it connects brain to the remaining part of the system, body. Okay, what it does? It connects brain to the remaining part of the body, rest of the body. Okay, it is the continuation of medulla oblongata. From medulla oblongata, it continues till the waist, up to waist. Could you clear? It is at the back, middle of the back. Okay, it is at back of our body, which is present in the middle. Okay, and its major function is send and receive impulses to and from brain. Okay, impulses and sends messages. Could you clear? It sends and receives messages to and from brain. Okay, it acts as center for immediate response. Okay, immediate response in sense, touching a hot plate, we have to take the hand suddenly. That is the immediate response. Okay, hearing a song, we started to dance. That is the immediate response. Okay, tasting a sweet and said like, wow, so sweet. That is the immediate response. Okay, this is the examples of immediate response. So for these responses, spinal cord is most important. Could you clear, children? So spinal cord connects brain to the rest of the body. It is the continuation of medulla oblongata and it is present at the middle of the back. Okay, so what are the functions of spinal cord? It sends and receives impulses to and from the brain, that is the messages. Okay, and also it acts as center for immediate response. Could you clear, children, about spinal cord? Very good. Now we are going to see about the another part of nervous system. Till now we saw about central nervous system, right? Central nervous system comprises of brain and spinal cord. Now we are going to see about peripheral nervous system. Okay, children, imagine that computers are connected in a network. Okay, how they will pass the message, with help of what object they will pass the message? Yes, with the help of wires, the computers in the network will pass message, or it will exchange messages, right? Likewise, nerves act as wires in our body. Could you clear? Nerves acts like the wires in our body, which is responsible for exchanging the messages between brain and the rest of the body, that is other parts of the body. Could you clear, children? How does the nerves looks like? It looks like wires connecting the computers in a network. Okay, here in our body, the all parts are interconnected with the help of nerves. Nerves acts like wires through which messages can be passed from brain to all parts of the body. Okay, these nerves constitutes the peripheral nervous system. Could you clear? What constitutes peripheral nervous system? The nerves in our body constitutes the peripheral nervous system. Okay, so how the nerves get divided? See here, the nerves get divided based on their carrying messages, type of carry messages, right? They are of three types. First one, sensory nerves. Second one, motor nerves. And the third one is mixed nerves. How the nerves get divided? Sensory nerves, motor nerves, and mixed nerves, right? First, we are going to see about sensory nerves. These nerves carry messages from sense organs to the central nervous system. Could you clear, children? That is, these sensory nerves carry messages from the sense organs to the brain. Okay, if you are touching a hot plate, these sense organs, that is these sensory nerves, will carry that message to the brain. Okay, the hand will send the message that I'm touching a plate which is so hot. Then our brain realizes, oh, you are touching a plate. So suddenly take your hand. This is what happening inside our body. Okay, what are sensory nerves? It sends messages from the sense organ to the brain. Okay, then coming to the motor nerves. Motor nerves sends messages from the brain to the sense organs. Could you clear? After sending the message by hand, that is, I'm touching a hot plate like that, hand will send message to the brain. And the brain immediately react to that message. So it will instruct our hand to take away from that plate. Okay, that is the help of motor nerves only we are doing like that. Could you clear, children? So what are motor nerves? They bring messages from the brain to the all parts of the body. Okay, to the sensory organs. Okay, then mixed nerves. It performs both the functions. Okay, it performs the functions of both sensory nerves and motor nerves. Okay, mainly they are present in brain and spinal cord. Where they will be present? They will be present in brain and spinal cord, right? So once again, what is peripheral nervous system? All nerves in our body constitute the peripheral nervous system, right? There are three types of nerves: sensory nerves, motor nerves, and mixed nerves. Sensory nerves carry the message from sense organ to brain, that is central nervous system. Motor nerves carry the message from central nervous system to sensory organs, right? And mixed nerves, they perform the functions of both sensory nerves and motor nerves. Where they will be located or where they will be present? They will be present in both brain and spinal cord. Could you clear, children? So children, here I am going to give some tips to strengthen our nervous system. Okay, since nerves plays an important role in passing, that is exchanging the messages, it is necessary to have a healthy nervous system, right? Here are those tips from which we can have the healthy nervous system for our body. Come, let's see about those tips, right? First is deep breathing, right? You have to have a deep breath. Then walking barefoot. Walking without any slippers or sandals, right? You have to walk in a barefoot. Since all organs in our body are connected to our foot, if we walked in a barefoot, it will be like a massage to those organs present in our body. So only they are telling to walk in barefoot. Could you clear? Then sunlight. Yes, it is the main thing from which we can obtain vitamin D, right? So sunlight is most important one for our day-to-day life. So we must consume sunlight in early morning and later evening. Okay, those rays will be very healthy, okay, and very helpful for our body to increase our immune power. Okay, next, yoga and meditation. They are simple exercise, right? So we must do yoga and meditation regularly in order to keep our nervous system healthy. Okay, then we have to consume food that are rich in magnesium and omega 3 fatty acids. These are very, very important. These food items are very helpful for the nervous system. So we have to consume those food items, right? Then Epsom salt. It is a kind of salt which is rich in magnesium mineral, right? It will help our body to get relaxed. Okay, so next, green tea. Yes, it is the tea that is leafy like structure, right? It is not a normal tea, it is a green tea from which we can be very strong and helpful for our nervous system to be more healthy. Okay, then chamomile. Chamomile is a herb which is used as sedative to calm nerves. It helps us to relax our nerves so that our nervous system will stay strong. Okay, children, could you clear about these tips? You have to follow any two from these tips so that your nervous system will be so healthy. Could you clear, children? Very good. So we came to the homework part now. So what is your homework, children? You have to browse the net and find the food items that are rich in magnesium and omega-3 fatty acids. Right? You have to list that separately. What are the food items that are rich in magnesium mineral? And what are the food items that are rich in omega-3 fatty acids? Alright? Find out and upload your work in Google Classroom app. Okay? Till then, stay safe. Stay connected. Okay? Do the tips. Okay, which I had said in this session to keep the nervous system healthy. Okay, do any one of those tips. Okay, it is better to do yoga and exercise and to stand under the sunlight, right? It will be very easy, no? So, perform those tips. Stay healthy. Okay, drink more water. Okay, so we can see in next session, right? Bye.